friends are gone. I don't blame them. I guess I move on, do the same thing. So I wrote a song to be my lullaby. Sing me to sleep at night, open my third eye. I'm not gonna lie to you, I miss you so much. Tell me what I did wrong to lose touch. I'm not gonna lie to you, this has been a hard year. Oh, I wish that you were here. I just need to let it go, waiting on a miracle. Guess it's just the way it goes. Easy come, easy go. I just need to let it go, turn it down and let it go. It's just the way it goes. Easy come, easy go. Sometimes I drive a little too fast. Think I'm running from demons of my past. So I wrote a song to help me slow down. Keep my mind straight, but it's a bit late. I'm not gonna lie to you, I miss you so much. Tell me what I did wrong to lose touch. I'm not gonna lie to you, this has been a hard year. Oh, I wish that you were here. I just need to let it go, waiting on a miracle. Guess it's just the way it goes. Easy come, easy go. I just need to let it go, turn it down and let it go. It's just the way it goes. Easy come, easy go. I just need a little bit of a miracle. Guess it's just the way it goes. Easy come, easy go. I just need a little bit of a miracle. It's just the way it goes. Easy come, easy go.
Sudan, Uganda, Burundi, Tanzania, Kenya, Egypt, and finally empties into the Mediterranean Sea. It supplies 11 different African countries with water and is considered to be the longest river in the world. The Nile is up to 36 feet deep and is a perfect waterway for large dinosaur-like animals to migrate south into the much more remote Congo Basin region and well away from the growing human population of North Africa. That all the dinosaurs died out 65 million years ago after a massive asteroid struck the Earth, causing a catastrophic planet-wide extinction. Therefore, no human being has ever seen a living dinosaur. ancient historical documents and many archaeological discoveries over the past 200 years tell a strikingly different story. He wrote, "When the dragon is drawn from its hole into the air, it stirs up the air and makes it shine. Dragons are found in Ethiopia and India." Ancient Egyptians also knew the giant long-necked behemoths that lived in the marshes of the Nile River. Here we see the Narmer palette, dated from the time of King Narmer. Among the many fascinating archaeological finds from ancient Mesopotamia, which is now modern-day Iraq, comes this ancient cylinder seal, dated at around 3,300 BC, and is likewise decorated with animals that look remarkably like dinosaurs, confirming that these giant plant eaters might have indeed survived until fairly recent. French is the official language and widely used in education and government. There are four national languages: Kikongo, Lingala, Swahili, and Shiluba. Regarding our mystery animal, the Bakongo tribe, who speak the Kikongo language of Congo Kinshasa, call the animal Mbokali Mbembe. That's Mbokali Mbembe. Now, in the Lekoala region of Congo-Brazzaville, the Bomitaba, Bomwali tribes speak three different languages, which are variants of Lingala. They call the animal by the more familiar name of Mokeli Mbembe. It is this name that Captain Ludwig Freiherr von Stein zu Lauschnitz noted when he was exploring northern Cameroon and southern Congo in 1913. It is unlikely in the extreme that all these ethnic and tribal groups, with all their uniqueness and diversity, speaking 600 different languages collectively in Equatorial Africa, decided as a collective to make up stories about a fearful, long-necked, long-tailed monster living in the rivers, swamps, and lakes. They don't like these monsters, and they don't like going into locations where they are most likely to encounter one. So why would they take tourists there? After all, a tourist gets killed in Africa, it's trouble for everybody.
music and online, and you know, I don't give a shit. I just wanted to go to this crazy place and see what we can find, you know. The Congo is the heart of darkness. There's an area of thick, dense, untouched rainforest about the size of Florida. It's the only area that survived the last ice age, and it's the last place on Earth believed to have living, breathing dinosaurs. The one the locals talk about the most is Mokele Mbembe. In Pygmy language, it means one who stops the flow of rivers, and it's fucking huge. It's supposed to be several times bigger than an elephant. Scientific expeditions come out every couple of years from all over the world. The British Army saw glimpses of it. National Geographic found something. The consensus is that it lives deep in the rainforest near a lake called Lake Tele. So that's where we went, and it was a hell ride.
Have to go there.
How old were you when you went?
18 years old.
Oh, was...
No, no. And then Vice, I'll bring it back to how that turned into Vice. But so I get on a plane, tons of lying and manipulating to get the visa because it wasn't open to tourism. It was only open to business. And so I make up this story that I'm a bodyguard to a toothpaste executive, and I work day and night to get a ticket to the Congo. And there's no tickets. It's this airline Aeroflot. And I'm in Israel, which is close to Africa, but because it's this Russian airline, I get on this flight. It goes to Moscow, and then Malta, and then like six other African countries, and then it lands in Brazzaville.
How long?
Like 3 days, almost, like and like a shaky airplane, you know? And you know, everyone in there is the ones that got to get out, right? So when they're coming back, they're bringing chickens and goats and all kinds of shit on the plane, and
wow.
It smells like shit. And I don't know. This is pre-internet, right? I don't have any information on the Congo except for I heard that there's a dinosaur there.
What year?
94. 94, 95. I lost track of time, but it was right after high school, so 18,
so
19.
No, you don't have a cell phone either.
No cell phone, nothing. Then I believed. Because the spiders are this big, and the frogs are this big, and...
How big are the frogs?
Just everything looks insane. The snakes. They got snakes out here this big? Like, it was like, okay, now I believe. Like, every year, scientists were finding a new species of something that they thought was gone, and I'm like, okay, and then I meet the pygmies.
Whoa.
And that was, fuck, I don't know what version of the story I should tell, because it can get so dark. I met a German guy named, fuck, I shouldn't say his name. I met a German guy there who was the same age as me, and this is in the city. And then he could tell that I was lost. I didn't know who this guy was. He was being groomed to be like the next big politician in Frankfurt or something.
Right.
And so I didn't get this until later. But he was here as his like sex vacation to fuck as many black women. He liked black women. So he's going to fuck as many. Curb your language, Dave. To have as many intimate relations with women as possible. Is that better?
No.
I'm trying to be better for myself. That's what happens is we go to the last spotting of it, right? And then I meet...
Is there any evidence at all? Like,
everyone I talk to? Oh, yeah. Yeah, we've seen it. Like, there's no, like, no, that's crazy. Every fucking person I meet is like, oh, yeah, it's in the last...
Is it one of those things where, realistically, there's not a whole lot of people looking for it anyway?
No, but there are scientists that go out there. And in the meantime, I've never seen anyone murdered before until I got here, right? I've been through the LA riots. I've seen things broken and burned down and guns pointed, but I've never seen anyone hung. I've never seen anyone stoned to death. And it's...
absolute chaos. I'm seeing people murdered. I'm scared for my life. I got attacked one time. So I go, I need to find, now I have to find this dinosaur. And I also know that there's a chance that I might never go home again. So I write a letter to my parents. How do I know if you don't try? You know, I still believed. I still wanted to believe. I was willing to risk my life for it. Start walking, there's a minor trail and then it disappears. It's just gone, and I'm like, we're fucking lost in the jungle. We're lost in the jungle. So I'm with this guy that the what we told people, he was here to fuck as many women as possible, but we went with the story of he is the toothpaste executive and I'm his bodyguard. That's a fake bullshit story.
Right.
As we're lost in the jungle, he starts to think that story is real. Hey, go fetch me a pineapple. I go, dude, I'm not your... He's like, you're not a real executive, bro. Like, I'm not going to get... And he starts, like, telling me, like, I'm like, hey, you know that was a fake story, right? Like, he's like, and there's no one around. So we get lost for days. And he starts to really be, like, humiliating towards me and right on my nerves. And we had rations. We went in with some crackers and some, like, tuna in a can thing. And I go, hey, man, we're fucking lost. I don't know how to survive. We need to ration this food out. I come. He ate it all. He ate it all.
Whoa.
And now, like, have you ever been in that kind of situation where you're like, I'm going to die here? Like, I'm never going to, like, hope is gone. Like, I'm in a thick, thick Congolese jungle. Like, I don't know how to get out. And we've been lost for days. Like, I don't know how to survive. I don't fucking know how to, like... this is it, you know?
That's insane.
And on top of it, I have this fucking German asshole who's, like, talking down to me, making fun of me, and eating my fucking rations. Like, I would pump all the fucking water and put the water purification tablets and be like, thanks? And I'm like, dude, what the fuck, man? Like, I did all that work so we could share it, and...
So he was just...
He was a dick. And so...
Man. And you're stuck in the
jungle. You've been in a jungle like that before?
No.
Dude, so we set up a tent. We have one tent, and so we're in close quarters with each other. The moon is like this fucking big. Like, it's humongous. And you hear the entire jungle come alive. Like, fucking monkeys and, like, things are bumping into the tent at night. Like, huge insects and, like, and I'm like, I'm gonna die here. I'm gonna die here. So, the few times in my life where I've been in this kind of hopeless situation, the only thing that's gonna get me out of it is if I can control my mind. Because I'm falling into despair. And in the daytime, I'm doing stand-up to the trees. Because we're just walking in, like, circles. And I'm like, hey, how are you guys doing all tonight? You know?
So you don't know where you are.
I don't know where I am.
Oh, my God.
I'm talking to the vegetation.
Oh, my God.
And this guy is riding my last nerve. And so I could safely say I lost my mind. So high.
Oh, my God.
It was so high.
How did you spot him?
He was shaking a little. From the place he was to get in front of us was seconds. Like, hi. It's like this short.
What's this jungle? I mean, when you're in there, do you even see sunlight through it, or is it just...
No, it's so dense. I mean, like, yeah, there's some cracks, but it's... Just this was also in the National Geographic why that the dinosaur would be here, is because cameras can't see it because it's such a dense, thick forest. And there's things in there that are, like, moving and, you know...
Dude, your description sounds terrifying.
It's terrifying.
Trying to sleep in the tent?
Oh, my God.
God, dude, I'm freaking out over here.
So the guy comes up. He's this short. He's, like, tiny. He's like, you guys want some honey? What?
Oh, my God.
And this is where my skill as an artist has gotten me out of so many situations. right? Because if you're in jail and you have any kind of skills, singing, dancing, telling jokes, drawing, you're saved. They bring us some honey, they bring us some fruit, and I'm like, oh god, I'm like just devouring it. They're laughing at us, and you know, it's like the National Geographic, like the women's tits are like down to their ankles, and fucking guy, he's an alien. He's an alien.
I told you.
1995. I was 19 dude. Years old. Yeah, 19 years old. Yeah, and they put that they put their clothes on for the picture, and they said, Dave, that is the fucking, and I told you, not the PG-13, but that story gets very dark, darker than what I said. And they go, will you go back with the camera and the camera crew? And I said, that was one of the most traumatic. I almost died. I saw people murdered. There was a fucking virus where people were bleeding out of their eyeballs. No. Okay, I'll go. Enough time had passed. It was 10 years later, actually. That was 95, and then it was like 8 or 10 years later. And
so that was the one that Vice filmed.
They're like, can you go
so
back?
So that photo for the Mickey Mouse shirt was from earlier.
That was from when I went with the film, like just my camera. So I go back, and how do we even get to this?
The dinosaur. They all see this same dinosaur?
Have you,
look at that.
There it is, Mokolo. Dude, you're fucking on fire, Jamie.
Holy fuck.
Yeah.
That one, number three is bonkers. What is that? Unless it's a log.
So I, on my second trip back, I met the doctor. There was a doctor that lived in the village close to that river.
Look at the track.
And he said he'd seen it.
Really?
And he's like not, you know.
I wonder if any like real legitimate biologists have looked at those tracks. Maybe they could tell you by the way the footprint, like they can kind of tell whether things are fake or real or not based on like how, where the weight is distributed. Like someone who really understands how these animals would walk. I think it would be really hard to fake dinosaur footprints, right?
Childhood traveling a lot, train hopping, hitchhiking, doing all these things. The sense of adventure, the sense of wonder, I don't know. Yeah, I guess it's real childish, but I wanted to see and go places where no one's been before. I've been reading about this dinosaur, National Geographic. Today. I haven't been here for 10 years. I've been with my group, Brock and Stefan, for 3 days now, and there's a growing dissent within our group. Other people in the group want to like pursue other stories, like I guess albinos are treated as gods out here. Another guy in our group is obsessed with trying to get a pygmy porn. This is not what we came here for. We came here for the fucking dinosaur. We've talked to experts, we've talked to scientists, we've talked to local sorcerers, and everyone's seen this fucking thing.
what I know is that before we came first in 1992, I grew up with family friends who were missionaries here. Gene Thomas and his wife Sandy was a nurse. They were going through this area where the river became a little bit wider. Right. It was almost like a pond or a lake. And he saw this huge thing raise up out of the water. And it sounds so dumb because this is what happens to everybody. Right. But he went to get his camera.
Right.
And he couldn't get it in time, and it submerged.
I ask you just to be very open-minded during your travels. It isn't the United States. It's not New York. It is Washington, D.C. Infrastructure is very challenging.
Right.
I don't know if they told you, but where you're going has very, very limited electricity, water.
Basically nothing, and exactly. Every animal and poisonous insect and every disease we can imagine.
Consider yourself sort of on the wilderness and on the frontier of Africa, but wholeheartedly support your venture here, and I wish you the best of success.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Nice meeting you.
Thank you.
Congo is the most biologically diverse country in Africa and one of the most important centers of biodiversity in the world. Encompassing over half of Africa's tropical forest and plays a critical important role in maintaining global climatic cycles. Home to over 15,000 plants and animal species, including more than 3,200 endemics such as the okapi, the Congolese peacock, and the bonobo. This wealth of nature makes the DRC a hotbed of biodiversity.
Got our team together, our pygmy force, to take us into the jungle. We got our guy here. He's got a nice Photoshop shirt of the dinosaur with the president. He's sort of like the Charles Grodin, Philip Seymour Hoffman guy of the group. Over here, we have Ben Kingsley, Sexy Beast guy of the group. And then over here, we have the Richard Grieco, Terrence Howard, Benicio Del Toro guy of the group. And this is our force to go into the jungle.
100 square kilometers includes forests, savannas, lakes, lava plains, swamps, erosion valleys, active volcano.
We were wandering in the jungle for a while. It was dark and light and disorientating. We got lost a couple times, and even with the pygmy guides. We would have been dead without them. Like, there's some areas that we can't even get through because we're so tall, and they're the only ones. Them and children are the only ones, and midgets are the only ones that could get through there. Looks like they're about to die. We're sweating like dogs. I've noticed the pygmies, they don't sweat and they don't fart. I think they don't fart because they don't eat any food.
So
So once we got to the village, the chief and his henchmen, they kept asking us if, you know, what we wanted to do while we were there. Did we want to go to the waterfalls? Did we want to go shoot pigs? Or, you know, we just said we wanted to see the dinosaur. And then they kept saying, do you want to see the dinosaur? Do you want to see this dinosaur? Yes, we want to see the dinosaur. Do you really want to see this dinosaur? Yeah, we want to see this dinosaur. So we had to do this ritual. And this ritual involved lots and lots of alcohol.
This is special for ritual. So we have to taste this.
So they pour us this clear liquid. It tastes like gasoline, and I guess it's made from manioc husks, and I don't know what else.
Tastes like fucking acid.
It put me on my ass right away.
Wow, I feel really crazy right now, huh?
During all this, looking over at Ben, he was doing this weird thing with branches, and I was like, fuck, man, is he like reading my mind right now? Does he know what a fucking scumbag I am? He was giving me this weird look, like he knew me.
That's a skinny dog. That stuff.
They did not stop, not to take a break, not to eat, and they just keep going, and they just keep going, and then, like some kind of dream or something, this thing just came out, and the people just screamed, and it was, you know, obviously it was a dude dressed up like something. He had all these leaves, and, you know, they were either saying he's an evil spirit, or it's the dinosaur, and I'm like, oh, I guess that's this dinosaur, and as fucked up as I was, you know, I was believing it at the time. It felt like there was a hole in my stomach. I kept staring at my feet. I thought my face was eating it, my own face, and I thought of eating my own feet. I thought I was fucked, and I knew I was fucked while I was fucked, laying there going, shit, this is gonna be really bad. Come all this way to see a guy dance around in a dinosaur costume and participate in fucked up rituals for the chance of maybe catching a...
The Congo River is Earth's second largest river by volume, draining an area of 3.7 million square kilometers known as the Congo Basin. Much of the basin is covered by rich tropical rainforest and swamps. Together, these ecosystems make up the bulk of Central Africa's rainforest, the world's second largest rainforest after the Amazon. The ninth longest river on the planet, and at over 220 meters deep, it is also the deepest. The Congo Basin contains more species of birds and fishes than any part of the African continent. Approximately 700 species have been recorded moving into the Congo River. Quite a few cataracts, dangerous rapids, and numerous islands can make the navigation difficult or impossible in certain areas of the river. The Congolese rainforest is known for its high levels of biodiversity, including more than 600 tree species and 10,000 animal species. About 45% of DR Congo is covered by forest, which provides a refuge for several large mammal species driven to extinction in other African countries.
Of Africa. It covers over 500 million acres across six different countries, and tens of thousands of species call this place home.
It is our planet's youngest rainforest, a mere 18,000 years old, and it's the jungle with more big animals than any other. In the last 20 years, poaching for bushmeat has halved the Congo's gorilla population. His kind are now critically endangered. Elephant, which needn't concern the silverback. But the elephant has reason to be wary of poachers too. Their long, straight tusks are even more sought after than those of their grassland cousins. Paths made by generations of elephants before him, searching for food. The silverback cautiously leads the way, but his family are close behind. Salts from the mud using their trunks.
Daisy, no. Daisy, get back.
Oh. I live.